Bea. Ik heb gekozen om een essay in te lezen van Virginia Woolf. Het essay is genaamd Thoughts on Peace in an Air Raid. Zij legt hierin uit haar feminisme, maar geïntegreerd in een breder kader. Wat is politiek engagement? En zij poogt hier in dit essay een uitleg voor te geven. The Germans were over this house last night and the night before that. Here they are again. It is a queer experience, lying in the dark and listening to the zoom of a hornet, which may at any moment sting you to death. It is a sound that interrupts cool and consecutive thinking about peace. Yet it is a sound that should compel one to think about peace. Let us think what we can do to create the only efficient air raid shelter. Up there in the sky, young Englishmen and young German men are fighting each other. The defenders are men, the attackers are men. Arms are not given to English women, either to fight the enemy or to defend herself. She must lie weaponless tonight. Yet, if she believes that the fight going on is a fight by the English to protect freedom, by the Germans to destroy freedom, she must fight on the side of the English. How far can she fight for freedom without firearms? By making arms or clothes or food. But there is another way of fighting for freedom without arms. We can fight with the mind. We can make ideas that will help the young Englishman to defeat the enemy. But to make ideas effective, we must put them into action. And the hornet in the sky rouses another hornet in the mind. There was one zooming in the Times this morning, a woman's voice saying, "Women have not a word to say in politics. There is no woman in any responsible post. All the idea makers who are in a position to make ideas effective are men." That is a thought that damns thinking and encourages irresponsibility. "I will not cease from mental fight," Blake wrote. Mental fight means thinking against the current, not with it. That current flows fast and furious. It issues in a spate of words from the loudspeakers and the politicians. Every day they tell us that we are a free people fighting to defend freedom. That is the current that has whirled the young airmen up into the sky. It is not true that we are free. If we were free, we should be out in the open, dancing or sitting in the window talking together. What is it that prevents us? "Hitler," the loudspeakers cry with one voice. Who is Hitler? What is he? "Aggressiveness, tyranny, the insane love of power made manifest," they reply. "Destroy that and you will be free." Women of ability, it was Lady Astor speaking in the Times this morning, are held down because of subconscious Hitlerism in the hearts of men. They are slaves who are trying to enslave. One of the terms of peace, the loudspeakers say, is to be disarmament. There are to be no more guns in the future. Do the current thinkers honestly believe that by writing disarmament on a sheet of paper at a conference table, they will have done all that is needful? The young airman is driven by instincts, cherished by education and tradition. Is he to be blamed for those instincts? Could we switch off the maternal instinct at the command of a table full of politicians? If it were necessary, for the sake of humanity, for the peace of the world, that childbearing should be restricted, women would attempt it. Men would help them. They would honor them for their refusal to bear children. They would give them other openings for their creative power. That too must make part of our fight for freedom. We must help the young Englishmen to root out from themselves the love of medals and decorations. We must create more honorable activities for those who try to conquer their fighting instinct. We must compensate the man for the loss of his gun.